Well, it's Throwback Thursday, and boy, are you in for a treat. The fabulous singer-actress Linda Purl is a Hollywood fave, has been for over 50 years. Gee, we've loved her in classic shows like Happy Days, Matlock, Murder, She Wrote, and, of course, she's made her mark on the big screen too. Recently, I had the joy, a pleasure, of chatting with the beautiful and ageless Linda, looking back over her stellar career, and we talk a surprising Hollywood romance. Take a look. Well, Linda Purl, this is an absolute treat. It is lovely to be Zooming with you.
I'd love to be there in person with you because I love Sydney.
Linda's big movie break came in the 70s in the Jonathan Demme-directed crime caper Crazy Mama, where she starred alongside some bona fide Hollywood legends.
It's where I met Cloris Leachman, who played my mother, and Southern played Cloris's mother. So just to be with those women at that moment in their careers was pretty spectacular.
We're going back to Jerusalem, Arkansas.
What the heck for?
I'm going to buy back our farm.
Cloris was a fierce creative force. When Cloris passed away, Donnie and I were lifelong friends now. We said, weren't we lucky to have worked with her so early on in our career? She was so influential. It was just a nice sort of one of those models that you got early on. Okay, that's how to work. That's how to approach the work. That's how to be on a set. Sunday,
Monday, happy day. But along comes for you two wonderful roles in Happy Days.
You must be Sheena Dubois.
In the flesh. These days
are ours. Is it true that your friend Donnie Most kind of suggested you come to Hollywood and that's how you got the introduction?
Absolutely. Donnie and I have been friends in New York. We worked together in New York at the downbeat of turning 18. Donnie had already gone out, and there was a role that came up on Happy Days, and so he called me. But if Donnie hadn't alerted me to that, don't think it would have happened.
I still got it.
Obviously, it was in the stars that you became part of the Happy Days family. How did that come about that you came back?
There was a casting notice that was put out that they were looking for a fiancé for Fonzie and they wanted a Linda Purl type. So, well, can I go up for that? And I did and auditioned for it.
May I take your order, madame?
Oui, très bien. Moi, je prendrai les cuisses de grenouille pour elle, le petit steak au
foin. Is she fluent or what?
It was curious because I was there at the beginning of the show and at the end, so, and not through that huge rise to super success that everyone had on the show. I love
my calendar girl. For Linda, Happy Days was an absolute joy to work on, and Henry Winkler, loved as the too cool for school Fonzie, well, he became an inspiration and a close friend. What was Henry Winkler like to work with?
My favourite story about Henry was we would film on Friday evenings. So on this particular Friday night, there was a Make-A-Wish Foundation had a young man who was out there. And so, well, this young boy, 9 or 10 years old, comes in with his entire family, so sweet. And we're all now in our robes and out of makeup and funny 1950s hairdos. And Henry comes in, not as Henry, he comes in as Fonzie. And I thought, oh, come on, how silly, really. What I didn't understand, and Henry did, the boy was not coming out to see Henry. The boy was coming out to see Fonzie. Hey! Make-A-Wish would afford the trip for the child and one supervising adult. So Henry picked up the expense for the entire rest of the family. And, you know, those acts of kindness say a lot about someone and say a lot about Henry.
Another career highlight was guesting on Murder, She Wrote, where Linda had the honour of working alongside the legendary Dame Angela Lansbury.
Most gracious, lovely human beings you could ever hope to know.
Oh, I see a friend.
She's very practically minded. She knew how hard the business was. And she paid it forwards on a regular basis. We finished filming and she had a dental appointment. Dental appointment, hell, it was root canal. And she came back to do off camera for me. I mean, who does that? No one. I could have done it with the script supervisor, with nobody there, but it was all about the work and the integrity of the work. So she came back, root canal and all. Thank you.
you became Lucille Ball's daughter-in-law. You married Desi Jr. and not only that, but you had Lucille's blessing. What was the private Lucille like?
By the time I knew her, she was not working anymore as an actress by choice. She had a very quiet life. She was an avid backgammon player. She had two girlfriends that they played every day for a number of hours. She had a lovely home with a beautiful garden. So that was her life.
Be wise, be smart, behave, my heart.
Linda Starr has always shone brightly, not just on stage and screen. She's also a much-loved singer and, from time to time, she takes to the stage with her ex-husband, Desi Arnaz Jr. Because in another side to your life, we know you so well on screen, but you're a great singer and, gee whiz, you got to meet some of the best in the biz, didn't you? From Doris Day, Peggy Lee, and even the great Rosemary Clooney.
Rosie had said to me at a time, it was not a happy time in my life, and she took me by the hand and she looked what felt like looking through me and said, keep singing, baby, the music will never let you down. And I knew that it was a big life note at the moment.
Well, lockdown wasn't all bad for some, including Happy Days star Linda Purl, who found love with somebody she'd known for decades. And that's Dallas star Patrick Duffy. They share their beautiful love story in this very special interview. Take a look.
Linda Purl has been a Hollywood favourite for over 50 years. Starring in some of TV's most loved series, from Happy Days and Murder, She Wrote to Hawaii Five-O. And it's now a real-life case of very happy days for Linda after being swept off her feet by Dallas legend Patrick Duffy.
Look at you two together. What a gorgeous trajectory this has been for you both, eh?
Yeah.
Well,
yeah, it was not planned.
But it just shows you you can create value out of any circumstance. There we were in the midst of the COVID lockdown. I was in Oregon, she was in Colorado. But after a couple of months of doing this very thing, it just became inevitable that we had better at least get in the same room if it was real. And we've been in the same room for 18 months.
You two, though, have got a long history because you knew each other years ago, didn't you?
In 1978, my first show, Man from Atlantis, was cancelled.
Yeah.
And I was given a script of this new show called The Young Pioneers to play, I think, a husband, I'm not sure, a husband, with this actress named Linda Purl. But I also got another script to play a five-part episode as a guy named Bobby. And I looked at one episode versus five episodes, and we missed our opportunity for 40 years, but then we made up for it.
Someday, when I'm awfully low.
We had bumped into each other at an event in L.A., I was doing a play in New York, and Patrick was going to be on the East Coast doing some work. And he said, well, maybe I can come through. And then the pandemic hit. And then we had nothing to do. So we started to Zoom.
Just the way you look tonight.
We texted for a few weeks, and then we FaceTimed, and then we discovered Zoom. And we ended up Zooming every single night for over 2 months, for several hours. Every night. And it just kept building. And then at one point, we signed off in a rather auspicious way.
Well, you did. It was like, okay, see you tomorrow. Okay. And Patrick says, okay, love you. I was like, what? When was that? End meeting. No way.
And when I hung up after, I said, what did I just say?
Yeah.
Oh my God, I used the L word.
Oh my gosh, hush your mouth. You'd come, Patrick, from a long marriage to your wife who very sadly passed away.
If you count the time we lived together, almost 48 years together. I thought that's a pretty good run by anybody's standards, especially in our industry and everything. And I didn't know even or want to try and figure out any plan of action. So the universe just stepped in and said, here's your plan. Just go for it.
Linda, true confessions. Were you a fan of Patrick's in his wonderful, though short-lived series, Man from Atlantis?
You know, I have to plead ignorance. I
Though allowed to return to his ocean existence, Mark decides to help us further our exploration of the oceans.
I had not known about it. I do now, and I've seen him in the Speedo. Street. Pretty nice. I'm sorry I missed out back in the day.
This is a great sadness to me.
Then help me. Together we can stop the flow.
Yes, it is necessary for us both.
You know what, it was a great series, Patrick. It was massive in Australia back in, I think, about 1977. And you had a swimming style that was unlike anybody else's swimming style.
Yeah, it was a young man's series. At that point, fun, exciting, and not difficult. When I think back, even doing it 20 years older than I was then, it would have been, you know, very difficult, and I probably wouldn't have lasted. So it ended at exactly the right time, and I got the next job right at the right time. I only had 7 days off between Atlantis and Dallas.
How did that come about?
One of our dear friends is the actor Gregory Harrison, and Gregory was doing a show next door to where I was filming The Man from Atlantis. And his executive producer was a man named Leonard Katzman. Leonard got the job of producing Dallas, and he was looking for a Bobby, and he had seen me around the set. He didn't talk to my agent, or he didn't come and talk to me or anything like that. He didn't even talk to the producers of Man from Atlantis. He went over and talked to the crew. He just sat around and asked questions about me. Was I a team player? Was I a pain in the butt? What, you know, am I late? Am I early? Whatever. So I didn't have to audition for Dallas. He just called up and offered the role to my agents, and I went to work.
You gave me the power to run that company, and damn it, I intend to run it.
We did 16 years of that show in total. I got to do everything that you could wring out of that character. I think the reboot could have gone a couple more years, but that would have changed the trajectory of everything else I did, and right now, I can't complain about a thing.
I know, that's right.
Need to talk to a detective about 2 missing children. The mother's hiding something.
The mother's name would be?
Laurie Vallow.
Not only is Linda and Patrick's rapturous romance powering along beautifully, but they've taken it to the next level by working together, recently on a movie called Doomsday Mum.
What was it like now having developed a relationship and coming together on the screen?
We thought, oh no, this could go horribly wrong, but it didn't. We found we had a similar work ethic, although to walk onto the set holding hands was odd, and at the end of one particular scene, I felt a pat on my derriere, and Patrick said, nice work, honey. It was like, what? Well, that's never happened.
Are you ready for a scoop?
I am here. I mean, my scoops are usually ice cream, but I'm ready for yours.
Well, you're going to get a double dip this time, Ben. We just, over the weekend, committed to make a tour of the UK for 5 months in the play 12 Angry Men.
Brilliant play.
It'd be restructured to be 10 angry men and 2 really pissed off women. Well, we don't know what they're going to call it, but we're going to work together and tour the UK for 5 months.
5 months on the road, wow.
With their relationship flourishing and the lovebirds smiling brightly, there's a question I just had to ask. Could a marriage be on the cards?
So a cheeky question, could it be possible at some point in the future?
Obviously, we're sitting examples right now that anything is possible. So, yeah, who knows? We don't know. We didn't know this was going to happen. I'm giddy with gratitude every single day I can wake up and look over and say, oh, my God, look who's in my life.
Well, we can't wait to see you down here. Let's make it happen.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having us, Greg.
Really lovely
to chat with you.
Fabulous was that. Don't you love a really beautiful love story?
Yeah.
And that was just one of the best. They were divine to chat to, as I'm sure you can tell. If you're a big Linda Purl fan, she has a website you might be thrilled to know. It's lindapurl.com. And that is where you can buy her albums. You heard her beautiful voice there. Also an array of photos, all of which she tells me she will very happily sign just for you. Pop them in a padded post pack and off they go.